Hey guys, I am the Metal Jesus, and today I am going to do another video about the 3DS. Specifically, this is going to be hidden gems. These are games that are not so well known, but are a ton of fun to play. Let's take a look. A game that is a bit of a surprise. Heroes of Ruin is a classic top-down dungeon crawler by Square Enix that will feel right at home to any Diablo fans. You have four classes to choose from. Now I'm playing as the Vindicator class here, which uses two-handed swords plus some magic, and really he just likes to hit things really, really hard. What makes this game so neat is that it is massive with lots of quests to take on. Plus, it fully supports multiplayer in the form of online trading, and also other characters can join your party through the internet. Now, if you don't want to play with other people, you don't have to either. This footage that you're seeing right here is me running around in solo mode, and the game seems to scale the difficulty to me just playing, which feels right. There are lots of NPCs to talk to, dungeons to explore, and barrels to bust open for delicious loot that you use to upgrade your armor, weapons, and items. For some of you, it may feel a little bit too much like other Diablo clones, but I got lost in this game, and you might too. Azure Striker Gunvolt, say that three times fast, is a Japanese 2D platformer that a lot of people compare to the Mega Man Zero or X series, but it has some new ideas that make it feel fresh. First off, you'll notice that this is a physical release that has two games in it. That's right, you have Azure Striker Gunvolt 1 and 2, making it a good value as they were previously only available as downloadable games. What sets the gameplay apart is the ability to tag your enemies and then damage them with your electrical field. However, you need to watch your energy as it takes time to regenerate. Your character also has double jump, air dash, and the ability to float when needed, which mixes up the gameplay in fun and interesting ways. This game requires a lot of skill and technique, and is certainly a challenge, especially at the higher levels when you unlock super moves that are needed to take out bosses. But the game is original enough to stand out in any 2D platformer fan's 3DS collection. Here's a really cool compilation of games by Namco, and with a title like Pac-Man and Galaga Dimensions, you'd expect to get the classic arcade ports, which you do. But to my surprise, there's a whole lot more here. You also get one of the only physical copies of the excellent Pac-Man Championship, which is a modern update to the game that adds a bunch more variety to the gameplay. And then you discover Pac-Man Tilt. This is amazing. This is a side-scrolling platformer that heavily uses the accelerometer and the gyroscope to manipulate the environment. As if that wasn't enough, there are also two updates to Galaga. Now, one is called Galaga Legions, which is a cave-like, bullet hell style shoot-em-up with really cool visuals and a serious challenge. Then there is a 3D on-rail shooter called Galaga 3D Impact, which feels an awful lot like Panzer Dragoon. You get a lot of bang for your buck with this collection, so I highly recommend it. Ghost Recon Shadow Wars is a turn-based strategy tactics game for the 3DS that I think is one of the biggest hidden gems on the system. This game is going to feel very familiar to fans of, say, Fire Emblem or the Advance Wars games, but it has a bit more serious tone thanks to the Tom Clancy license. Your soldiers or ghosts play several roles on the battlefield. You have things like a commando, sniper, gunner, medic, also a recon, which has really cool futuristic see-through camouflage, and then also an engineer that can drop turrets. And each of these ghosts have their own statistics, equipment, upgrade path, and abilities to help you play through the lengthy campaign. I also want to mention that this game takes full advantage of the 3D aspects of the handheld really well, since the height of the terrain and your character's position can greatly affect your line of fire and also your ability to withstand damage. Now, it's not necessary to have the 3D on, but I think the game plays better with it. If you like turn-based tactics games, this is a must-own. You know, I don't know if I've told you this before, but I love puzzle games, and I also have a secret love for really bad full-motion video games. Well, I'm here to tell you that James Noir's Hollywood Crimes is a groovy mix of both for the 3DS. In the game, you play as a contestant on a TV game show in the 1960s that gets mixed up in a murder mystery that may or may not actually point to you as one of the suspects. What I like about the game is the campy dialogue and characters, but the puzzles are solid and mixed up nicely for variety. You'll get physical puzzles, logic puzzles, math puzzles, and more. Now, admittedly, it isn't as well made or as polished as, say, the Professor Layton series, but if you're looking for something new to challenge your noggin, and it's usually found cheap, check it out. It just may make you smile like it does me. Next up is Pilotwings Resort, which was a 3DS launch title, but for some reason has been all but forgotten by gamers, especially those late to the handheld. And that's a real shame because this game is really good. Now, if you played a Pilotwings game before, say on the N64 or especially the Wii, you kind of know what to expect here. This is mostly a relaxing game of flight with some aerial challenges, all while you're switching through different modes, like say using the rocket belt or an airplane or a hang glider. Now, my favorite thing to do in this game is to fly around the island looking for all the collectibles that unlock different modes and aircraft. Also, I have to point out that probably my favorite minigame is the balloon chase. Now, this is where you fly your airplane while you're chasing a car that is hanging balloons from the roof. And then you're trying to shoot them while you're trying to fly and avoid obstacles. It sounds crazy, but it's super fun to do. This is actually a really cool game. Next up is Frogger 3D. And the reason why it's on this list is because the original Frogger arcade game is one of my all-time favorites as a kid. See, I always come back to this game because it's the perfect mix of risk versus reward. Now, thankfully, the original is included in this collection, but there's also some really neat surprises. The biggest upgrade being a complete 3D reimagining of the classic game, which adds more complexity and brings the game into the modern era. For instance, in this new version, there is a goal on the playing field, but it changes location each level, and now there's new challenges and rewards. Also, there's a really neat infinite mode for the original arcade game, where you try to see how far you can get on one life, and then you compare your scores. Now, I know what you're saying, Frogger may look simple, but the gameplay is timeless, and this is a really neat modern version of it. I'm a fan of crossword games when I'm looking for maybe a bit more casual gaming experience, but I still want a challenge. Well, CrossWords Plus works nicely, and it's a sequel to a popular DS game. Now, if you've played a crosswords game before, well, this one's gonna feel right at home, but it certainly won't win any awards in the design department. It's not ugly, but it's pretty basic. However, it doesn't really matter what it looks like, it just needs good puzzles, and this game literally has thousands of them, both big and small, easy and challenging for all gamers, and it provides countless hours of entertainment. Plus, you can pick up even more puzzles through Spot Pass if you want. It's hard to talk in detail about a crosswords game. Everybody knows what they are. But if you enjoy these type of games or you're just looking for something different, definitely check it out. All right, so that is some hidden gems on the 3DS. But as you guys know, there are a ton of games released for that system. Love to know what you guys would like to see me cover in the future. If you have some games you'd like to see, please post it in the comments below. I'm always interested in getting your feedback. Also, I did a 3DS buying guide, and I will link to that up in the corner. All right, guys, as always, I want to thank you for watching my channel. Thank you for subscribing, and take care. You know, it seems like most of the 3DS hidden gems are actually digital only in the eShop. And I did a video on that a while ago, but it should really be updated because there's probably literally hundreds of new games in the eShop that I haven't even played yet. So I'd love to know down in the comments if there are some eShop digital-only games you think I should know about. Let me know. Thanks.
Nice socks.
Thanks. I work out. See, they're workout socks. Kinda.
Nice workout socks.
Yeah, thank you.
Let me shoot this whole thing like this.
You can't wear those black tall ones because people make fun of you. At least that's been my experience.
Yeah, try garters. Sock garters are awesome.
Are those the ones with little clips?
Yeah, little clips that go up around your calf.
Huh.
Yeah, once you turn 50, you have to wear those. I don't know if you knew that. But I've gotten to like them.
Do you have suspenders?
I do.
I need to get a pair of suspenders.
Yeah. It clipped right up to my my butt cheeks.
So like your nipples, just right up here?
Nope, you know? The butt cheeks. That's why I use Bader butt lifters to keep my butt cheeks
Bader's butt lifters.